Hey guys, if you put God first and you choose to live for Him, He does bless your life. He gives you peace in times where you can stand in a situation in this world, so many things going on around you, and you go, why have I got peace? It's because of God. It's because I know God. Me and Pheeps were, there was a situation 2 or 3 years ago where we were in the hospital. We had something reasonably major affect our lives and demanded right then and there radical change. And I remember when the doctors came in and told us. And it was an incredibly gutting thing for both of us, I have to be honest. But in that moment of guttingness, right at that moment as they told the news, as much as I was gutted about that, one of the greatest senses I had in that moment was the peace of God, knowing His covering. And you know why I had that? Because I have a relationship with God. And I've chosen in my life to put Him first. And as that moment, as we were in the hospital, I was able to comfort my wife. We had other people going, and I remember I walked some people out of the hospital who came to see us. And as I walked them out, I didn't even know what they're saying, because I was just in my heart, I was dazzled by, Lord, Your peace. Now, how we talk about blessings, I want to say God does. He blesses us financially. He blesses us in so many other ways. But how is there more bigger blessings than that, than personal in your life? And to be honest, when you make a decision for God and you choose Him, why would you ever look back when you can get moments like that? Why would you ever look back and say, for example, you're in a family situation where things are cut up, it's turmoil, but you know, whether sitting outside or going by yourself, you're not alone. You've got a Creator God who's watching over you saying, it's all right, I love you. The Bible says there's nothing in all creation that can separate us from the love of God, and in moments like that, knowing that love. What can compare with that, guys? What's a greater blessing? And if you need to know that, and if you've got situations tonight and you need to know that, but you don't feel like you're quite in connection with God, tonight we're going to give you the opportunity to do that. That's going to come up in a couple of minutes. We're just going to jump to the last part of the verse now. It says, such is the generation of those who seek Him, who seek Your face, O God of Jacob. Lord, You're awesome. Basically, this is what a generation of people who seek God look like. This is the generation of people who get to stand at the top of the hill and meet Almighty God. As I said before, there's no being like God, and nobody with a heart for You like God has. But I want to tell you something, the thing that gets me about this verse, this is awesome. That God isn't saying that is the generation of people born in 2007, nor is it the generation of people born in 1922. I don't believe God puts it on the time that people were born. But He says it is the generation of people who seek Him. I want to challenge everybody in this room tonight, and it's up to us. It could be every single person in this room. We could be the generation. We're talking about preparing for the next generation, but what better way to start with us? See, I believe, if I was to be prophetic now, speak, I believe that God is putting out a call to the people of this generation, of this day, you and me. And this verse is what it looks like. He's painting the picture of what it is to have a people wholehearted after Him. And He's challenging us, saying, this could be you, this could be me. But God looking down is saying, in this room tonight, this could be you. This generation could be it.